make sure everybody that we need on the open issue list is here. And then we'll get started with that. And then we have folks who are joining for the follow-on meeting. I'm just going to give it about 60 seconds here. Okay, Lynn Hartenberg here again. So I'm Logic, Clarino, Mike Isbell. Who else is from our normal service request? Bud Carl is on the line.
And join the conference.
I haven't heard Krishna. I haven't heard Budrish.
Yeah, Budrish, I'm sorry. Why
Ava?
Yes, that does fix the package that you had
the conference.
That you called out, but it also touches like 175 different other objects. And we're just not going to apply that patch. That's just, I mean, the amount of testing that would require is just, it's just not worth it.
Ben, I understand your concern, but folks, CDC, KB, we're not able to give it because it's not feasible to give the one-off patch for this file. It has a lot of dependencies in it, so it's not feasible, basically. So I would suggest to go ahead with the patch, which I have suggested, to fix that issue, veteran issue.
All right.
Hey, Brian.
Is there a workaround that we can do? Like, if we manually create these POs, will it go through? Or is this like a submission check thing?
Is this a submission check?
So even if we built these POs out manually, we'd still run into this process, is what you're saying?
Yes.
I mean, that's just unacceptable. I just...
Because you do have a lot of lines in the PO, right? Even if you are submitting it manually?
40 plus, yeah, I'd say.
And the number of distributions on the purchase order?
The number of what?
Distributions.
Yeah, about 40 plus.
Basically, this is a validation issue on the distribution when there are several distribution lines are having the same error.
Was this a bug introduced by something? Because, I mean, we have, you know, tens of thousands of POs, many of which have, you know, distributions, 40-plus distributions, all with the same acronym. So why is this just now an issue when we've processed many, you know, 40 plus distributions all with the same acronym before?
Basically, I'm not commenting on the number of distributions, like exactly 40 plus or not, but this issue happens with distributions when there are a large number of lines having the same acronym. I cannot exactly comment how many lines
onwards
the issue happened.
Okay. So what if we processed like a PO with 10 lines, sent that through, and then modified it, add another 10 lines through that through, add another 10 lines through that through. Would that work?
Yes, that should work.
We're not gonna apply that patch. So we need to figure out Oracle needs to give
okay,
us
you can, you, yeah, you can try that out manually, Brian, and I think that should work.
Okay. We'll get back to you on that then.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Next item, the stale data error message that it looks like it's still in testing. And I'm going to try to kind of move through because I know we have this follow-on meeting, but if I'm going too fast, just let me know. Okay, the next one. We had a conversation with Krishna last week about you had concerns about the queries for this, but I didn't see an update to the SR. Do you want to talk about that some more?
Okay. Well,
it's a fun those auto close due to, you know, I know there's activity on your side, but in the Amazon, there isn't. So if the owner or somebody else can please just go in and just provide an update, that would be great so it doesn't auto close. Any other questions or concerns about that one? All right, then the newly added line issue, the SR ending in 7831. This is a Harika. Harika is unable to attend today, and I wasn't able to get an update from her. So what she asked, and I'll be happy to follow up on your behalf, or you can do it directly. She asked that on a couple of these that Madrisha and Krishna reach out directly. And you know, by email and get updates. So I don't, you know, just let me know what you prefer for me to send the email and copy you, or if you want to reach out directly to Harika.
I'm okay with notify. I don't need to. I can wait another week.
Oh, okay, great. Okay, thank you. Thanks, Christian. Okay, the next one, PRDS. I did get an update from Harika on this one, issue ending in 5-4-1. She said she'll be uploading the test patch for the PRDS 2.0 by tomorrow after performing a dependency analysis. So I think we missed our ETA by a few days, but I think the ETA was August 28th. So apparently we should get that.
And join the conference.
25th or 28th? 28th.
Maybe I'm looking at my old report here.
Yeah, RPMO is very leery of the idea of using test patches anymore. And so
So again, Krishna, I don't know if you want to reach out directly to Park or if you want me to, you know, send an email. It's completely up to you how you wanna get an update.
Okay.
Are you needed? So yeah, Krishna, just tell me if I mean, I'm happy to reach out to her and talk to you, but if you think it's easier for you to just reach out, it's completely up to you.
so I'm gonna actually hang up.
Okay.
No, you don't hang up because you're on the phone, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, perfect. Okay, so Debbie, did you get the questions that I sent out? Okay.
No, I
did. Okay, perfect. You got I'm sorry. You got the questions. Perfect. Yeah. So you got the questions. So how do you want to do this? Do you want to just go through it, or how do you want to do it?
Control is at
only template controls at the project. Some agencies want to control at the org level, which is a separate segment, so we have that flexibility also. It's not controlled by summary templates.
So any increase or decrease is, as I said,
everything is controlled from our project cost budget. So every agency has its own cost budget type. And every time they increase and decrease, we use our cost budget to manage that. And our PFE hook, which we have, your integration hook, that's what we use to increase and decrease the sub allotment entry in FedEx.
Okay. And then you manually go ahead and update the cost budget.
Yes. Right. So most of the agencies have it manual. Some agencies have an external system which they feed us the project, the cost budget in project. So we have an interface to bring those level budget because some agencies want to plan their stuff in an agency outside because right now they are not using our Hyperion currently. So they send us through like bigger agencies like MDA. They send us our cost budget through via an interface. But when that cost budget is established through that interface, we take that and we interface it into FedEx.
Okay.
Everything is tracked by project, so we have that, and then from the project perspective, that's how these the agency managers manage their project. They use the PSI and they all have our standard features to monitor their budget at the task level. They see the task going up and down because the charges are coming at the task level and expenditure type level, so they use PSI and other reports to manage it at the lower level, but the funds are controlled at the project level.
Managed meaning they only kind of monitor it and
yes,
ensure that it doesn't go out of whack, but not absolute control.
Not absolute control. Task is at the project level, so that is only for the funds are controlled at the project level.
Funds are controlled, and that too only in GM.
Not project. We stop there.
$10 million, but the project you created
workflow errors out.
Cannot, we need to have the budget established even for the project. The budget has to be established. budget out for a single year, and it depends upon whether it's a single year, multi-year, or a no-year fund. That is part of the year-end closure process.
You don't have project or program-based fund?
No, we don't. No program-based. We do have a flex field value, but currently we are not allowed to use that. Yes, prior year adjustment happened, and we have those special T codes transaction defined in Fed Admin. So when if there is a prior year adjustment happening, we know, based on our fund setup, we know whether it is expired or not, and then we fire the FP transaction type accordingly to account for them.
Okay, and transaction type. All we send in FE is the transaction type.
and then setup takes over and sends those entries into GS. So we, when the transaction type happens, we have current year transaction type and then we have expired transaction type. To adjust the budgetary.
Do you have the fiscal year as one of the
yes.
segments?
Yes.
Sure. your pleasure.